Welcome back to Gate Baba. In this lecture, I am teaching the steady state conduction with internal heat generation in a rod, in a circular rod. Okay, so here I am showing the diagram, circular rod with having radius R naught. It is the center O and is having radius of R naught and the length of L. Okay, here the assumptions are same, steady state, one dimensional. And heat here, the heat is generated throughout the volume, not at a single point. The assumption is the heat is generated at each and every single point with the same quantity. It is not generated unevenly. So the heat generation is a volume phenomena. It is not a point phenomena. So the heat generation will be constant throughout the section, throughout the volume. Okay. Here my intention is to find the temperature at a given radius. So if the examiner asks to find at this radius, what is the temperature? Or at this radius, what is the temperature? Or at this radius, what is the temperature? At this radius, what is the temperature? Then I have to use the conduction equation. So, what is the generalized conduction equation for a cylinder with one dimensional, with heat generation? What is that? It is d by dr of r dt by dr plus Qg R by K equals 0. It is steady state, so that's why there is no time term here. And internal heat generation, that means Qg term has to be there. Okay, if I integrate this one time, here my intention is to find the temperature profile. So I have to integrate this two times because here there are two times derivation. So to get rid of those derivations, we have to integrate two times so that we will get two constants. If you find the constants, then our problem is solved. Okay, let's start with first integration. It will become R dt by dr equals minus Qg R square by 2k plus C1. Okay, now I am taking R this side, then it will become dt by dr equals minus Qg R by 2k plus C1 by R, right? Again integrate, then it is the first equation. Again integrate, it will give T equals minus Qg R square by 4k plus C1, for 1 by R it is ln of R log of them R plus constant C2. It is my second equation. Here I need some boundary conditions to evaluate C1 and C2. So what is the boundary conditions? It is a case of steady state conduction. So throughout the surface area, the temperature is constant. And I am taking the temperature as T naught. Why? Because I am taking the radius is R naught. So I am representing the temperature with T naught. In the plane case, I am representing the temperature with TW. Here I am doing with T naught. So here the surface area, this is also temperature T naught throughout the surface area. The temperature is constant because it is steady state. At any time, the temperature is constant throughout the surface area. And that is our first boundary condition. What is that? At R naught, at R equals R naught, the temperature is T naught. And what is our second boundary condition? The temperature is maximum at the zero radius. Why? Because the surface area of the cylinder is in contact with the surrounding air. So definitely some heat loss will be there due to convection heat transfer, but the inner volume is not in contact with surrounding. So definitely the heat loss will be less when compared to the surface area. So definitely the temperature rise will be higher at inner radius. So if the temperature profile may look like this. Okay, so it is the T naught temperature and it is the T maximum. So at T maximum, the slope is 0. Just rotate this diagram to 90 degrees, then the slope is 0. Here I am drawing this diagram in horizontal direction. Okay, so that's why it is like a vertical line. It is like infinite slope, but it is not like that. Otherwise, you can change the coordinate system also. It is the T naught, x axis as T naught and y axis as R. Then also the slope is 0. Okay, so the slope is 0, dt by dr is 0 at r equals 0. So at radius 0, the slope is 0. And these are our two boundary conditions. Just apply the boundary conditions. I am applying the second boundary condition initially, so that dt by dr equals 0 at radius 0 from this in equation 1, c1 becomes 0. Okay, and our first constant is 0. Then we have to find the second constant, and for that we need to place the second boundary condition at r equals r0. The temperature is maximum, that is, sorry, the temperature is T0 at R equals R0. So T0 equals minus QG R0 square divided by 4K plus C1 is 0, no need to substitute, plus C2. So here the C2 value is T0 plus QG R square by 4K, and that is our second constant value. If you just substitute these constant values in the second equation, then our temperature will be at any R minus QG R square by 4K minus QG R square by 4K plus T naught plus QG R square by 4K. Okay, here it is QG R naught square, sorry, R naught square. Here also R naught square. Okay. So from this equation, T equals T naught plus surface temperature plus, I am taking the QG R, QG by 4K common, QG by 4K, then the equation becomes R naught square minus R square, or also it can be written like this also, T naught plus QG by 4K 1 minus, I am taking R square common, R naught square common, sorry, 1 minus R by R0 whole square. Okay, so it is my final answer. With having thermal conductivity, only conduction consideration, okay, not convection. If I want to consider the convection also, then I will replace T0 with T infinity term and H term. Okay, just check this whether it is correct or not. How we check that? Just apply the boundary condition. We know that at R0 the temperature is T0, okay, whether it satisfies that or not. Just substitute R equals R0, then R0, R0 will become cancelled, and 1 minus 1, 0, 0 multiplied by QG R0 square by 4K, again 0. So temperature is T0. Yes, our derivation is absolutely correct. Okay, if you want to check at R equals 0, then you just put R equals 0, then it will become T0 plus QG R0 square by 4K. We know that definitely the maximum temperature should be greater than T0. So the term is T0 plus QG R0 square by 4K. Here R0 is definitely positive value. QG also positive value. K also positive value. So this is whole term is positive value. Then definitely the temperature at the middle will be greater than the surface temperature. Again, our derivation is correct with respect to the second boundary condition also. Okay. Now I am just interpreting heat transfer concepts here. Whatever heat is generated within the rod, that must be convected away with surface transfer. Okay, so that means the total generated heat QG volume means pi r square L, pi r naught square L total volume. Okay, equals the total generated heat will be convected with outer surface area, that is H A delta T. A means outer surface area. 2 pi r naught L outer surface area delta T. Delta T means T naught minus T infinity surrounding temperature. If from this I will get the T naught value, I just substitute the T naught value in above equation, then I will get the total equation in terms of H and K and surrounding temperature. Okay, so just substitute, just cancel this equation, pi r naught for one time L. Then from this, if I rearrange the terms, then T naught will be surrounding temperature plus QG R by 2H. Okay, QG R naught by 2H. Okay, and this is the relation for wall temperature, surface wall temperature in terms of surrounding temperature and heat transfer coefficient. Just substitute this value in this equation, then the T equation becomes very big. Okay, you just remember the big equation, then you can do whatever you want. just put R equals R naught, then you will get the wall temperature. If you put R equals 0, you will get the maximum temperature. Okay. Now write down a note here. And that is to find the QG. In most of the cases, the heat generated per unit volume will be given in the question. But for sometimes, it is given indirectly for electrical conductors. Okay. For electrical conductors, you have to find from the given data what is the generated heat. We know that when a current is flowing in the current carrying conductor, the heat generated will be, it will not be QG, capital QG it will be. Because we are not dealing with the volume, here we are dealing with the total heat generation. The heat generated will be I square R. Okay. And these units are watts, not joules. If I use I square RT, then it will be joules. Here I am not writing I square RT, I just writing I square R. So it will be in watts, no problem. Okay. Then you have to find the QG. That means per unit volume. Per unit volume means just divide the above expression with volume. Then it will become I square R divided by volume means area into length. Here area is pi R square and length is the length of rod or length of cylinder you can take. Okay. And it is our important expression. In case of, it will not be provided in the exam, you have to use these relations to find the heat generation. Sometimes he may not give directly the resistance and current in direct forms. He may give resistivity and current density. Then the resistivity is represented with rho and that is given as Ra by L. Okay. Here, from this equation, you will find the resistance from resistivity. Rho is resistivity, not resistance. To consume your time, these type of questions will be asked. Until now, there is no question, but may be expected. Okay. And I also not directly given. Sometimes you may give the current density. The current density is represented with small I and it is given as capital I divided by area. Okay. Just remember these relations. If the problem is of electrical conducting problem. Okay. And that's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching.